In our feature segment today, sugar beets. The chances are good that the sugar in your sugar bowl came from sugar beets grown in the northern part of the United States. Now, the high price of corn in recent years has prompted some Wisconsin dairy farmers to turn to sugar beets as a cheaper, better feed source for their cows. Mark DeMarcus' Josh Bittner explains.
Autumn in the Midwest offers a colorful backdrop for farmers taking to the field to reap what they've sown. And while fall harvest is a common sight across the land, what one group outside the town of Anago is pulling out of the ground is anything but typical for America's dairyland.
I think we're the only ones in Wisconsin so far growing them to feed cows.
Though sugarcane, a tall perennial grass which houses sugar in its stalk, is grown in states with more tropical climates, over half of the entire U.S. sugar supply actually ripens underground. Sugar beets, cultivated in a wide variety of temperate environments across the nation, store sweetener in its root.
That's about a 7-pounder.
Over 1 million acres of the sucrose-producing flora are grown annually in the U.S. According to USDA, the land of 10,000 lakes reported a record 12.3 million tons of the crop in 2012. And while the Red River Valley region of Minnesota and North Dakota has traditionally logged hefty yields, companies like Minnesota-based Beta Seed seek further expansion by scientifically augmenting sugar beets to offer what it claims is the best nutrient balance among livestock feed options.
This is just over 20% sugar. We call them feed beets because they're meant for feed. The feed beet's going to bring the sugar, the carbohydrate, and then also the digestible fiber, and it's a one crop.
For many livestock owners, feed can be their highest annual expenditure. While most cattle feed is corn-based, some producers near sugar facilities have been able to take advantage of the sweet crop's added nutrition. Trucking in this alternative ration has rarely proven cost-effective. But swapping out nearby cornfields with sugar beets is a notion that's picking up steam.
What really spawned this whole thing was when the price of corn hit $6, $7, that we had feedlot operators calling us, hey, can I plant beets? I mean, I love beet pulp and I'll feed it all day. Can I get more? Can I grow my own beets? Well, certainly you can. In Wisconsin, obviously, it's a number two dairy state in the country, so there's a lot of cows here that could use this type of forage to, you know, maximize their milk production, and beets are a great fit.
Though California has overtaken the Badger State as the nation's top dairy producer, Wisconsin's strong infrastructure remains intact. Farmers looking to compete in a global marketplace must keep an eye on the efficiency of their operations. And sugar beets are highly effective in this regard because of the slow release of sugars locked in the plant's pectin, a dietary fiber. For cows, consuming beets may create an ideal digestive process capable of improving the quality of the animal's liquid commodity.
Sugar beets are 80% digestible versus corn. Corn silage is only around at 45. So in theory, the rumen has more available to their stomachs. So in return, we should make more milk and that's less going out the back end. Cows will utilize it faster, more efficient.
And proponents say sugar beets employ cornfield nutrients more effectively than the grain itself. While corn roots permeate the soil up to almost 2 feet below the surface, sugar beet roots, reaching 6 to 8 feet underground, scavenge for deep excess nitrogen that corn can't reach. Preliminary results indicate higher yields from beets versus corn when considering the same field area. Mark Moss, along with business partner Mark Brown, launched a speculative venture with Beta Seed, who cut Evergreen Dairy a deal on feed beets for their initial planting. And now the dairy partners are poised to benefit from the new feedstock. Brown also holds an interest in another dairy farm outside Green Bay, which is introducing feed beets to cows.
Our idea was to raise the beets in two different areas of Wisconsin, going to two different breeds of cows with two different sets of nutritionists so that once we get these beets harvested, that we have a good understanding of how they feed and what we can do with them in a diet.
Jeff Bentley is a third-generation dairyman near Pulaski, Wisconsin. With a herd of around 1,900 Holsteins, the idea of expanding feed rations intrigued him. While dairy prices currently are above most producers' cost of production, Bentley still sees room for improvement.
We're hoping for some savings, but if we could keep everything equal and have a healthier cow, I think it's going to be worth it. As a dairyman, we watch the markets. I'm a buyer of corn, but the price of corn and all feeds being high has brought the price of milk up because of, the price of everything. The sugar beet is a way maybe for us to get a little niche market and use our ground a little bit, more advantageously, especially up in north of Green Bay.
The extremes of the upper Midwest climate are capable of wreaking havoc on corn and soybean fields. Though genetically modified seeds have allowed more resilience in the face of wild weather swings. Sugar beets provide a drought-resistant crop which basically lies dormant during periods of intense heat. But when water returns, the plant resumes growth. And post-harvest, a textbook Wisconsin winter could offer the benefit of cheap outdoor storage before the product reaches its consumer.
If you get 55 degrees or cooler root temperatures, it makes for ideal storage. Comes down to how much can we raise this crop for versus, say, growing corn or hay. I'm from the Minnesota, North Dakota region, and our typical cost of production on beet production is on the low side, maybe $22 a ton to as high as $30. Corn silage is in that $28 to $30, $32 a ton range, so it comes down to what's going to cost, your input cost per cow. Should be better with beets.
For Market to Market, I'm Josh Bittner.
And you can watch this story again on Sugar Beets on our Farmweek website, Facebook page, or YouTube. You can also see the video and the script at Market to Market's Iowa Public Television website. Our website address, farmweek.msucares.com. We're also available at twitter.com/farmweek.